Hey there, home assistant enthusiasts! Today, we are diving into a topic that might sound familiar to some of you, the overcomplicated home assistant setup. Now, don't get me wrong, pushing the boundaries of customization and tinkering is part of the fun. But let's talk about the mistakes that some of us have made along the way. Picture this, an intricate web of connections spanning across external databases, visualization integrations and a fleet of Raspberry Pis, desktops or enterprise servers, all forming a high availability home assistant cluster. Sounds impressive, right? But let's break down where this complexity can lead us astray. We'll start by opting for MariaDB instead of the default SQLite for data storage. Sure, it might offer more robustness, but it also adds a layer of complexity. And here's the thing, for many Home Assistant users, SQLite does the job just fine. MariaDB might seem like a power move, but it is vital to question whether the benefits outweigh the added complication. Then there's the decision to connect to Grafana and InfluxDB for visualization and data storage. These are powerful tools, no doubt. But Home Assistant already has robust features for data visualization and storage. Straying from these built-in tools can lead to headaches in maintenance and updates, and most importantly, performance. Next comes the temptation to create a Home Assistant cluster from Raspberry Pis, desktops or servers. Sure, it is cool to experiment, but keeping them up to date can be a nightmare. Remember, Home Assistant's monthly release cycle means updates are frequent. Can you ensure this complex setup will remain stable through each update? Just think if simple backup restore procedure with the embedded Home Assistant tools will not be much faster if disaster happen with your setup. The KISS principle, or keep it stupid simple, reminds us that simplicity often wins over complexity. Now, let's talk about integrating not so well maintained custom integrations. While this might seem like shortcuts to fulfilling unique needs, they can become ticking time bombs. As Home Assistant evolves, these integrations may fall behind, causing issues during updates. Sometimes it is better to opt for officially supported features that are more likely to adapt seamlessly to changes. Let's tackle the allure of crafting intricate custom dashboards and themes. They look stunning, no doubt. However, building complex dashboards can quickly become a double-edged sword. With each new Home Assistant update, the risk of compatibility issues increases. While it's tempting to create something elaborate, remember that a simpler dashboard is often easier to maintain. Also, remember that Home Assistant have embedded tools to change the look and feel, as well as light and dark mode support, even automatic one. So, what's the takeaway from all this? Well, the complicated setup can certainly work once, but the real challenge lies in maintaining it to work seamlessly through every Home Assistant update. Remember the KISS principle and keep it simple. A well-organized, straightforward setup is more often robust and easier to manage in the long run. Share your thoughts and experience with complex and simple setups in the comments below. It may sound as cautionary tale, but try keeping your Home Assistant setup simple and you avoid a lot of headaches and you enjoy your smart home more. If you found this insight helpful, don't forget to check my Home Assistant webinar for more. It is all free. I'm Kirill, happy automating fellow enthusiasts, and until next time, bye!